experience fear a lot of times.
As long as it is just an experience and you honestly acknowledge it, every such experience will burn away the seed from where this fear comes. Every time you experience without yielding to the experience, every time you experience without being afraid of the experience, you are letting the experience burn something inside you. It's like there is someone who is firing a revolver at you. And how many shots does the revolver have?
Six.
Every time you are able to survive a shot, what have you done? You have heightened your probability of survival. Now he has one bullet less left. Something that was firing at you has burned down. Something has burned down without harming you. So it has burned down and you have not been harmed. That is how you have to go through experience. Every time you experience fear without yielding to fear, please see that your past conditioning has reduced a little. The more you can stay this way, the less frequent will the incidences of fearful experiences become.
Later on it will not come.
It is already not coming. You see, you haven't yielded to fear, so has it come? It is already not coming. Please see, the fellow is firing at you, but have you been hurt?
No.
What will change then? You are already not being hurt and you would later also not be hurt. The only thing that would change is that the fellow would be exhausted and he would no more be firing at you. His ammunition would be now burnt down, exhausted. But you have not changed. You were not hurt even when he was firing at you. And you are not hurt now that he is not firing at you. So your condition has not changed. You have remained in your unhurt condition. So remain in your unhurt condition. And slowly you will find that the situations that cause hurt to you will diminish in frequency. You really want to fly free, and that is why you are so afraid of flying, right? Are you afraid of something that you know that you would never do? What are you deeply afraid of? That which you know that you are attracted to. If something is dangerous but it does not attract you, is it really dangerous? You would never step into it, so there is no danger. Something is dangerous only when it is not only dangerous but also attractive. You are attracted towards that. It is your own attraction that you are scared of. It is your own attraction towards largeness, towards greatness. Are you ever contented with smallness? Anything that is small, does it ever satisfy you? More and more and more. In a relationship, you want infinite love. You want infinite security. Even money you want infinite. Does any limit ever please you? So there is that within you which is never satisfied with the limited, and that is what you are so scared of. It would never let you remain in boundaries. It would never let you remain in confinement. But when you come out of confinement, it is a danger to your existing systems, to your prevalent patterns, to your current emoluments. Your conveniences are risked. Now you decide what is better. To keep feeling strangulated, confined, but secure, or to let yourself be drawn towards that which will keep you calling, which will keep calling you till your last breath, and who knows, even after that.